That's Bay. Hey, let's do it.
All right, what's going on? Here we are, Wednesday afternoon. We're styling and profiling, getting ready to do another fun interview right here. But before I get into that and introduce you to my guest, I tell you each and every time, this show and all of our shows is brought to you by Next Home Brandywine in Downeytown, Pennsylvania. Our good friend, Mr. Dan Peasy, and his team of professional realtors, they're going to provide you with guidance, knowledge, and information for all buyers and sellers. Go to nexthomebrandywine.com for all the details or to contact an agent. They do service Philadelphia and the surrounding counties, but nationwide referrals are available. Be sure to ask for the NH5 listing special or just give them a call directly. 484-364-4862. That's 484-364-4862. And just let them know Totally Driven Entertainment sent you. So, my guest, he came prepared, sporting his killer coat. And I said, wait a minute. And I went into my closet because I have the same coat. So I figured, we got to do this.
Let's do this, man. Great.
Let's welcome my new friend, Mr. Aaron Dalla Villa. Aaron, what's up, dude?
Hey, what's up, man? Happy to see you, man. Happy to be here. Shout out to Brandy Wines. What?
Shout out to
Pennsylvania.
Yeah, I can already tell we're going to have a good time. We're going to have a lot of fun on this interview.
What we got? What are we talking about today? I don't even know what we're talking about. What are we talking about? Let's talk about something.
All right, let me ask you the most important question of the interview. Because, I have a feeling you're a fellow Italian like myself.
Definitely, bro. Come on.
So is it gravy or sauce?
Sauce, man. All day. It's all about the sauce. You're a gravy guy?
I'm a gravy guy.
Okay. I only get into gravy when it's Thanksgiving time. But besides that, I'm all about the sauce. Whether it's my marinara sauce or my pasta, or it's the different type of sauces. I love Thai food. I love Chinese food. I love all the different types of sauces, man.
I'm about the sauces too. But when it comes to my macaroni, it's gravy. It's Sunday gravy.
Yo, I don't really put gravy on my macaroni. I got to try that. How delicious is that?
So,
That's next level.
I'm going to have to send you over my grandmother's recipe. This way, you can make yourself some. And
I'm a terrible cook, by the way, but I will try it. Let's do it.
You know what? It's easy. It's just a lot of throwing stuff in a pot and letting it cook up. You got to cook a little meatballs, a little bit of sausage and, But yeah, it's nice. It's nice.
Right, so, dude, you send that over. I'll make it and I'll get back to you on that.
There you go. So you're like this uber multi-talented in every faceted direction. Acting, music. I started even looking in deeper. You were a dancer early on. That's how you started in this wacky business. You're a writer. You do it all. Like, how did starting at a young age as a dancer spiral into all these other realms of entertainment?
First off, thank you. And, you go into life thinking I'm going to do this one thing, I'm going to be a professional dancer my whole life. And then God has a funny way, the universe, call what you want, higher power, has a funny way of being like, oh, you have plans. Okay, boom. Next thing I know, I'm getting involved in acting. Next thing I know, and it was all through out of necessity. My need to go into acting came from an injury. It was a slight injury in dance. It was a sprained ankle. It wasn't even something serious. But it was out of pure necessity to survive that I said, I got to do something else while I'm waiting to recover. So I said, screw it, I'll act. And I jump on Craigslist, literally, to find my first job. And my first job was in Chicago, acting-wise, outside of school. It was a show called The Dinner Shoe Players. It was based on – no, The Family Shoe Players. It's called Dinner with the Family. It was based on Tony and Tina's wedding. And okay. That's like an Italian mob story in Chicago. It was a terrible show. But I had a like because literally I'm like this 19-year-old kid playing a 40-year-old's part who's a restaurateur And I'm 19, you know, I look young now, but even at 19, I looked even younger. And it was literally, I'm running the restaurant. So it was hysterical. And I threw on this Italian accent. And you know what? We had a blast, though. But that opportunity led to other opportunities. And it just kind of steamrolled. Someone from the cast was like, hey, you're really good. You should have an agent. She connected me to the agent. I got involved in background work. I booked a few commercials. Then I booked my first movie with Paul Sorvino. I didn't even know who Paul Sorvino was. And as you know, he's an Italian legend, my man.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Goodfellas. I mean,
yeah.
So I walk on set and I'm at three scenes. And one of the scenes is with Paul Sorvino. The movie's called Chasing Gold. It was my first movie I did in Chicago outside of a student film. And everyone was like, oh my God, it's Paul Sorvino. I had no idea who he was. I talked to him for like an hour about dance. Literally, he just starts talking about acting, dance, so down to earth. And I was just like, this guy's really cool. And then he remembered me. He remembered me 2 years later when we ran into each other in New York at an event. He remembered me. He said, oh, you're in that movie I'm in. Yeah. He's a good dude.
That's awesome. You know, it's funny because I was sitting there and I was thinking to myself too, like as I was going through all this stuff, I'm like, you could be like the male version of J-Lo and we can call you A-Davi. A-Davi instead of J-Lo.
A-Davi. I think that, you know, I've been going as A-D-V. You know, I'll like go as A-D-V. My rapper name is Dalla Villa. Well, that's my musician name because I'm more than just interested in more than just rap. I like pop. I love EDM. I'm a big metal fan too. Classic rock fan, Journey, Billy Joel, all that stuff. Like I prefer the old music actually more than the new age stuff. But Dalla Villa is my name for a musician. And then ADV is what I go by. But some people call me, a lot of people call me Dalla Bills too. The Dalla Bills is
like
a name of mine. People like, hey, you're at Dalla Bills. I walk into the room, they call me Dalla Bills. So I'm cool with that. I'm cool. I like having all these different names, you know, that places I go, people know you as different AKAs and stuff.
That's too funny. Yeah. Now, going back to the dancing thing, I saw you were actually where I am now. You were part of a Nashville ballet company.
Wait, you're in Nashville, Tennessee right now?
Yeah, man.
Yo, I love Nashville, Tennessee. Nashville, Tennessee has a part of my heart. I danced in the second company in Nashville Ballet, and I had the opportunity to perform with the first company several times. My biggest occasion with them was playing the court jester in their production of Cinderella. It was one of my best experiences I've had. And then I also worked restaurant jobs while I was there at, you know, the local taco? The local
taco on
Murphy Road. What about Park Cafe?
No. No, I've been here a year.
Park
actually,
Cafe, man. I'm telling you.
It's my one-year anniversary. It's 2 years ago. 2 days ago.
So if you ever get to Park Cafe, they have a drink named after me. It's called the Tiny Dancer. Because that's another nickname they would call me, Tiny Dancer or TD.
I got to write this down.
So literally, they got a drink named after me at Park Cafe. It's called the Tiny Dancer. And it's funny. I don't even drink. So I think it's still there. Last I heard, it's still on the menu. You know, hopefully, with COVID, Park Cafe is still open. You know,
what part of town is that in?
Murphy Road area.
Murphy Road. Okay.
You know, West End Avenue.
Okay. Yeah. That's where I first moved here. That's where I was living on West End Avenue.
Word. My first job was working at that Chipotle Mexican Grill when I was 18 at. On West End Avenue. That was a busy location, man. I was the fastest cashier in the Midwest. You know, I could swipe cards. Let's go. Let's go.
That's awesome. That is awesome.
I clean the bathrooms in 10 minutes and stuff. But don't get me wrong, man. I've hustled. You know, I've worked all different types of jobs and stuff. And yeah. So.
And now you're hustling in the entertainment industry with you know, you're doing movies, you've done some TV stuff, you're doing, which we, since we got the coats on, let's talk Tucci and Jones off the bat.
Yeah, dude. Well, this jacket, did you have a chance to watch Tucci and Jones?
I saw the first episode and
you know what's going
yes.
on.
You're right.
Do you love Vinny Vitadici or what? Isn't he
Come
a great
on.
Character?
I want him to manage me.
Right. I know. So he's that guy who's like, I channeled him after Ari Gold. Ari Gold is one of my dream roles to play. You know, Entourage. I think that just character is so much fun. Jeremy Piven's a great actor. He killed it. But I want to, so I channeled it after him, but I wanted him to make him a little more in his head, you know, a little more ridiculous. So I put on two different types of animal print. I slicked the hair back. I made it white, you know, and I wanted him to play opposite Tucci Bottaducci. And people are really loving that web series. We shot it for literally nothing. We pulled a bunch of favors. We shot it in a week, all 8 episodes. And we said, you know what? We just want something with this Tucci guy that I created and just put it out into the universe. So we just did it. And now it's out there for the world to see. And people are really liking it.
Now, did you write that too?
Yeah. So I co-wrote it with Black Wolves Productions. So the people over at Black Wolves Productions and I, we actually scripted it like, you ever seen the show Curb Your Enthusiasm?
Mm-hmm.
So Larry David, what they do is they'll hit bullet points. The thing doesn't have a script. It has, this is where we're going to start. This is where we're going to end. It has actions that happen. So literally we'll be on set and say, okay, we need to hit these points that Tucci, a rival rapper, shouted him out on a diss track. We got to do something about it. Here's the problem. Here's the solution. Go do your thing. And then we'll improvise with that. So the whole thing is improvised.
Wow.
The whole series is improvised.
So, yeah. Now, how long, I mean, when you're doing episodes like that and they end up being, you know, 5 to 6, 7 minutes long, like how much actual shooting does it take to get down to those 5 minutes?
Hours, you know, to get the right thing. And especially we were shooting... We shot 8 episodes plus the music video in episode 8. There's a full-on music video. I had people.
Oh, nice.
I had like 25 people in my studio apartment, like chilling and stuff. Like literally, I'm setting off the smoke as well. The smoke alarm in the hallway's going off because I'm, you know, smoking it out with a fog machine and stuff. We're getting pizza delivered and stuff. We went wild and out, and we shot it all. It was a back-to-back furious shoot. Yeah, I'm talking 8 to 12 hours a day for a week for 8 episodes, and we're just banging it out. Sometimes we're just like, we got it in 2 takes. We'll be like, we got it. Next point.
Yeah, I was actually like, I was saying to myself, damn, we should have did this interview yesterday for Tucci Tuesday.
Tucci Tuesday! Yes. So what they do is on Tucci Tuesday, so the whole series is on YouTube right now on Black Wolves Production, the deal I made with them. They'll drop it on Black Wolves Production. Okay. They'll drop on their Instagram. They're dropping episodes one by one to drive people over to the YouTube. And if they don't want to go over to the YouTube, they're just going to have to wait a week to see the episodes. And I drop teasers on mine telling them that the whole season is available.
Gotcha. Gotcha. Nice. Now, is there like a plan to do any more with that, or is there like a hope to try to get it picked up to get onto like a Hulu or Netflix or something?
So basically, we just put it out there. We're just going to let the audience kind of decide how they feel about it. We've already got some people saying, I want a season 2. Let's see a season 2. So I'm already talking to the guys about where we can go with season 2. I want to expand Vinny's part, of course, because what we may end up happening is that Tucci now gets realized by this god rapper at the end of the season, and maybe there comes in a management war of people trying to rep Tucci, and Tucci's like has to be crossed between, do I stay with the person who's been with my career for the longest time, or do I move up? You see what I mean? And that happens all the time in our industry. And I think that'll give Vinny some, you know who the fuck I am, I will put, you know, it'll like go off, you know what I mean? So... So we can't reveal that I'm crazy to people, okay? So we can't do that, babe. No, I'm kidding. I'm joking.
Keep it low.
They already know. I'm not crazy. I'm just eccentric, energetic, passionate. But, okay, so we have plans to do that. And then also, yes, I do have plans if the opportunity presents itself to pitch the show. I just want to build up the streams and popularity of it right now.
Right, right. Yeah. That's awesome. Now, you also you got these couple movies right now on Hulu, which I want to get into. But You also ended up on an episode of Gotham. Like,
it's awesome.
How was that?
It's my first. Well, it was my first co-star. My first co-star was Late Night with Seth Meyers, but I consider Gotham as my first co-star because I had to audition for it. Gotham was a direct book. I mean, Late Night with was a direct booking. Gotham was my first audition, first co-star debut. It was a pleasure. 14-hour day working opposite, you know, the Riddler, Corey Michael Smith, and it takes a lot of energy. That show is so heightened that literally you need so much energy for the scene. Wow. Because of the world that Gotham creates, it's such a heightened show. It requires so much energy. So by the time they flipped it to Corey's side, I was literally drained.
Yeah. It was such a great show, man. Yeah, I loved that show.
No, it was it was mad expensive to make.
I can imagine. I can imagine.
I spoke to one of the producers on it, and he was like, "Yeah, you know, this is a really expensive show to make."
I was shocked when I met Ben McKenzie once, and I was shocked like how small he was. I was like, "Whoa!"
And they appear so much bigger in life.
Yeah, you know? Yeah, crazy. So, with these two movies now, Pledge and Trick. Now, the funny thing is, you know, with the whole Tucci thing, and for some reason, like I was thinking to myself, I need to like see if he knows Jamie Kennedy, and then I see he did the movie with Jamie Kennedy.
Yeah,
I grew up with Jamie.
Dude, I grew up watching you watched the Jamie Kennedy experiment.
Yeah, yeah.
I watched the Jamie Kennedy experiment when I was growing up, and I thought it was the coolest thing. And when I found out, I wasn't in a scene with Jamie Kennedy, but I was in a movie with Jamie Kennedy. And that's cool, you know. Yeah. And I met him at Screenfest, and he was such a down-to-earth, funny guy. So that was a really cool experience. But, yeah, to be in that position where it's so crazy, man. You grow up thinking, oh, yeah, I watched that person. Then later on in life, you're in a movie with that person. It's right. It blows my mind. You know?
I grew up with Jamie and went to the grade school with him.
Where? Whoa. Wow. Wait, yeah. So where did you go to grade school?
It's a school called St. Alice. We both grew up in Upper Darby, Pennsylvania, right outside of Philly.
Wait, did Omar Epps and Jamie can go to the same school as well?
No.
Oh, okay, cool. Because one of my friends went to school with Omar Epps. And I didn't
okay. Know yeah. Yeah, so it's funny because, you know, I was living in Philly. I moved to Nashville last year. But whenever Jamie would come back to town for stand-up or whatever, we would get together. And somebody had posted that there was a picture of me and him and some other kids like outside the little corner deli one day during school. And we're out here like, he's doing this and I'm behind him giving bunny ears. And the last time he came to Philly, we reacted to the picture. It was funny.
That's awesome, man. Awesome. Got to keep those traditions, man. Traditions never die.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. So that movie, Trick, that seems like it's a – Trick, that one seems like it's a real party.
it's got a great turn. It's got a great turn. It's a classic. You know, Patrick, the director, he wanted a classic slasher movie, and that's what you get.
Yeah.
That's a classic. I mean, it's just right around the corner, Halloween. I got fans that have literally seen that movie 7 times.
Really?
They've seen the movie 7 times. They love it.
So. And it's what it seems like. It seems like it's that classic slasher movie that, you know, that and that horror genre is so huge and people love that stuff.
And it's getting bigger because now you're seeing bigger talent and stuff like Chris Rock and Samuel Jackson.
Right.
Jackson doing Saw.
Mm-hmm.
The next Saw part in the Saw franchise. Isn't that crazy? You would never think. You would never think, you know? And now horror is something to be – I love that for the genre because I have found that horror fans are the biggest, most loyal fans in any genre. And it's just it's nice to finally see them getting the attention, horror the attention it's deserved.
It's funny too. I was going to say like, you know – like once you're in, like it seems like now that you're in there, you have you know Trick and you've done this other movie Pledge, which is kind of along the same genre. You get into that genre, like you're in, and then you got that whole world of the horror conventions. You know, if you can get into that and then on top of it, try to get into like one of these superhero movies, like you're set for life with the convention scene.
So basically, here's what I got coming up next. Speaking of superhero movies, I have my own original IP superhero movie as one of my movies coming up. I have, yeah, it's called Alpha Rift, and I play a fanboy who's a comic book nerd, villain.
Okay.
He's not a villain. He's the hero of the story. He's a comic book nerd who runs a game store who turns out that his this comic book that he grew up listening to and stuff, he's the original bloodline to fight off the age-old demon. So it's an original superhero action fantasy movie. So I'm attached to that. If that franchise blows up, then that'll – there you go. I've got the sci-fi angle and I've got the horror angle. Now, I'm not just interested in doing horror. I love doing thrillers. I love crime movies. I love gangster movies. I love Scarface. I love all that stuff. You know, narco stuff that deals with that. I love heist movies. I want to do a heist movie. Like, there are a lot of things I want to tick off my bucket list. And I also have a comedy coming out as well, why I get to play the comedic relief in this one.
Right.
But yeah, no, that's coming down the line. A super, an organic IP original superhero movie. And I'm already in the horror community. So
that's awesome.
I'm excited the way things are coming. And I got a secret weapon that no one's ready for, dude. No one's ready for this, dude. I got a secret project that literally, I think we're really going to blow people away. It's from the it's from the makers of Pledge.
Cool. Yeah. Now, Pledge, that looked like I was watching a trailer for that, and I said to myself, this is like Animal House gone wrong.
Right. Bingo. Bingo. And that's a huge market. That is a huge market, the whole fraternity thing. And that right. kind of stuff that happens in Pledge is still happening. People are like, this is crazy. No, that is – some people brand people in fraternities. They do this kind of messed up stuff.
It's crazy. And there was that whole thing like with that whole hazing thing that came out a few years back. You thought you would think that it would put a stop to it, and no. You know it didn't.
People are dying from this kind of stuff because the links that we're willing to go to make people like us, that's a crazy reflection on our society.
Right.
That's a bad thing, man.
Which one are you more like proud of? Pledge because you get the bigger role in it, or
because having that bigger role, I was able to explore more sides of the character. So I would definitely say Pledge is the one that I'm more proud of for sure.
Nice. So like now that these are like on Hulu, and you know, it's kind of like the best time for all that stuff too, with people, you know, with the whole COVID pandemic thing, and more people have been stuck home lately, where I'm sure like, you know, years ago people got in the entertainment business and they were kind of like, I don't want to end up on Hulu or Netflix. But now it's like, I do. It's get me on there.
Where else are you going to go? The movie theaters, who knows when they'll return, or they're back and, you know, limited seating or limited run. And to get people to even get out of their house and their whatever to go see your movie is tough. People started – we had a limited release for Pledge. This was before COVID. And the movie took off when it hit Hulu. So, yeah, man, it's a streaming platform. It is a streamer's paradise.
Absolutely. Now, how about how have you been through, you know, the whole COVID situation, the pandemic situation? Because, I mean, obviously you're a guy who's – you're a creator. You're an entertainer, a creator, whether it's the acting or the music or your writing – have you been doing, because it seems like you released the music this year officially. So was it like, did that inspire it? Because you now that you were locked up or?
Absolutely. I was sitting on lyrics. I was sitting on songs that I've had for years. And I said, you know what? It's time to put that out there. Or else I'm just going to keep trying to get over this fear of what other people are going to think about my music and stuff. So I'm happy I just did it. And COVID kind of forced me to do it. It forced me to just be going to hyper creative mode. I gotta do something, man. You know, I gotta do something. So, but I'm also blessed because I was able to stay pretty busy through COVID because I was into voiceover work.
Okay.
So
yeah. Nice.
I got my setup, bro. I got straight up like, hold on, let me see that. Like a straight
up. Oh, yeah.
Dude, yeah.
Look at you. Okay. Yeah. That's awesome. So music wise though, like had you, you never recorded anything before or not even for yourself?
Yeah. No, I was in a boy band. I was in a boy band before I dropped these tracks. Like literally we had two songs. We had one song dropped on Spotify. We were about to go live with our second song and we had a deal apparently with H&M or something. The manager told me and this thing fell apart because someone's actions in the group.
Oh.
Yeah. And that is going to be revealed in the secret project I got going on.
Interesting.
Yeah. So I was actually in a legit boy band. Like we rehearsed and yeah.
Are you going to unveil the name of that secret boy band or?
Oh, the boy band's called, it was called We Are Nation.
Okay.
It was called We Are Nation, yeah. And before that, it was called Fast Four. And in between that, it was called The Current. Like, yo, it went through, dude, it was a mess. Like, 2 years, it went through so many iterations, so many different opinions and whatever and stuff. And imagine while all this, I'm trying to focus on acting auditions and stuff. So I like to say that things happen for a reason, but I want to say that with the band falling apart, I learned so many things from being in that band that I took those experiences and skills and applied them to my solo work.
Nice.
And my third song that I just dropped is a collaboration with the boy band manager, with Paul Anthony of Full Force. So, yeah.
Cool. Very cool. So out of all these things you're involved in, whether it's the acting or the music or, you know, doing writing or even dancing, you know, which would be your one true love?
Acting. It's acting right now. It's acting. You know, that's the one that I'm most in love with right now. Don't get me wrong. I can go through spouts where I fall out of love with acting, you know.
Sure.
Viola Davis talks about this. She says, I'm not in love with acting all the time. There are times where I'm like, I fall out of love of it, or I fall in love with something else more for a time. But it always comes back to acting, creating those characters, being on set, being in front of the camera. That's some of my favorite moments.
Well, how about, I mean, it's gotta be too, like as an actor, I mean, We've seen your personality for the last half hour talking to you. You're a fun guy. You're a happy guy. You're fun. You're ready to have a good time. And then you play this role in The Pledge where you're a nasty SOB.
SOB, dude.
Yeah, you know.
And isn't that funny? You meet a lot of people who play those mean people and stuff, and they're the nicest people outside. And
right.
You're like, wait, you're the same person?
Right, right. But I mean, it gives you, you know, it's got to give a credit to you on your acting. But how does that play on you mentally?
There definitely has to be a moment of decompression. You have to, after going that deep into someone who is that psychotic,
right,
and narcissistic, you have to. I literally would carry the character home with me sometimes. So I would have to decompress, come back, hold on. You are not, you know, the golden boy of a secret society and a fraternity. You are Aaron Dalla Villa. You're just a dude in New York trying to do your thing. Calm down. You know what I mean? So you have to decompress.
How about getting into that role?
Oh, so much fun. So you know what, I this may sound crazy, but sometimes I feel more alive playing roles than I do as me. Is that interesting? Is that weird to say? Is that sometimes I feel more alive when I get to play a character than myself?
Which is kind of weird to say, because you are kind of a character as well.
I am a character. That's why I think I'm I guess when I'm playing a character, it's a more defined character that I can see, okay, these are the color reds and these are the color blues and these are this what this thing is. As Aaron is always evolving. So I can never be like, oh, these are the color reds, these are the color blues. It's always evolving. You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah.
Interesting. So, all right. So music-wise, anything else coming out this year do you have going on? Or?
Yeah. So I got another track that I'm working on right now. It's for the secret project. I'm talking to the director now if he wants me to release it beforehand, the secret project, or when it comes out. And then I've got another track that the director for Alpha Rift, the superhero movie I'm in, he wants me to write a song that he wanted to shoot a music video that would go side-to-side promo for that character. So I'm writing a song for that character right now. And then in one of the movies I have coming out called All Those Small Things, I play a sort of Justin Bieber, Kanye West guy who's really endearing but sort of dumb. Who it mixes jazz and rap music together. And I wrote two songs lyrically for two songs that are in, that are sampled in the movie as of right now. Yeah. I haven't seen the movie yet, but as of right now, I have two songs for that one when the film is released that I will have to my own name that I can release too.
Does the coat get any more screen time?
This coat?
Yes.
I mean, this coat, definitely when Vinny Vinadici comes back. And actually, this coat was inspired by my character, Tiny Hammer. I kind of want to show you a picture. Do you see that guy over there?
A little bit.
The red coat he's wearing?
Yeah.
Oh, he dressed like this. That character inspired me so much, Tiny Hammer. He dressed in like a phoenix, you know, kimono, and he had, you know, like a red, like long fluffy coat with chains and spiky hair and goggles in the house. He just didn't give a damn, and he's really rubbed off on me. My characters, you know, the good parts of them have rubbed off on me, and I said, you know, I really like this I like this character.
Nice.
But it also, it helps me find who I am too, playing these characters, because then I see who they are, and then it helps me understand myself more.
I'm sure.
So it's pretty
cool.
That's
wild. Yeah. So how about now acting wise, what's the next thing that's coming out? Do you know offhand?
Yeah. So I've got those three films coming out. I'm shooting something. I'm shooting a co-star for something in LA in October as of right now, unless it gets canceled, you know, because COVID and stuff.
So now, where are you at? Are you in New York still?
New York.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
And right now I'm in New York. And I do have a voiceover for a fragrance brand, but it's been pushed to next year. So hopefully they're still planning on releasing it next year. So yeah.
Gotcha.
So yeah.
Cool.
See what I mean? You just got to keep moving and keep working. And I'm attached to several other projects, but I'm waiting to hear what the deal is with those.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, this has been a lot of fun, man. This
it's
was
awesome,
a lot
dude.
Of fun.
This is great, like, man.
Yeah. So if you ever get to back to Nashville, or I get up to New York at some point,
it's a done deal. We're friends now. It's a
absolutely.
Done deal.
Yep. Absolutely. And I'm gonna look into this Park Cafe and find out if this Tiny Dancer drink's still
yeah,
there.
Yeah, let me know if it's still there and tell them that we had a chat.
I will.
Some of them maybe still. Yvette and Willie, I think they still own Park Cafe. They'll know who I am. You'll say, "Is the Tiny Dancer here? I met him."
I got to ask my girlfriend. She's been here for 13 years, and she's actually from New York. She's from Brooklyn.
Oh, excellent.
Nice. Too funny. So, where should we send everybody to? The music, the movies. Let's get all them plugs out there.
All right. Well, they can Google me, Aaron Dalla Villa. They'll find me. Instagram, if you want to keep up with my Instagram, follow me at Aaron Dalla Villa. On Hulu right now, immediately Pledge and Trick. I'd recommend you watch Pledge because that's I have more screen time in that. And Tucci and Jones on YouTube is right now. Just type in Tucci and Jones. They got to watch that. And then Dalla Villa on Spotify to listen to the music.
Awesome.
So, yeah, cool.
Aaron,
dude,
you're the man.
Thank you, Bay.
Don't take the coat off. I'm wearing it now.
Man. I got to go into another interview now, actually. So.
Well, have fun, man. And great talking to you and great connecting with you, man.
Same, brother. Thank you.
Congrats on everything.
Thank you, brother.
Take care.